Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala barakatuh. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin was salatu was salamu ala ashrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Alhamdulillah, with the grace, mercy and permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we continue our Ru'ya IIH, Integrated Islamic Healing Methodology, which I'm going to develop inshallah in the future. And we are doing this recording as part of our book, in a material for the book, and also for training you in terms of Ru'ya as well as Islamic Integrated Healing, which is very important, especially in the modern world where everything is just based on the physicality of existence. So we have our website right now new, that is Ru'ya IIH, which you can subscribe, and there are many videos coming up every now and then. We have the video in English as well as in Bahasa Indonesia. And as usual, our Islamic Psychology PIP, we have more than 500 videos. We have all the rest. So we have many channels. This is a preparatory work for our Khalifa Education Foundation and Islamic Psychology Center to transform the Ummah. So inshallah, when this whole series of videos is completed, along the way, we will do a lot of promotion. So subscribe to any of our videos, especially if you're interested in psychology, interested in holistic healing, interested in Ru'ya, and inshallah we can give you some ideas how to go about within the framework of the Quran and the Sunnah. So we have many modules in terms of psychology, which we have given to you: motivation, coaching, mentoring, Islamic heart of love, which includes the Islamic holistic integrative healing. And I've mentioned in the previous videos that we have to transform the Ummah, because positive transformation using positive Islamic psychology methodology is very important for us, for the self, the family and Ummah, as we face that climate disaster that all of us now we know that within 30 years, if we don't do anything, this whole world will have catastrophic disaster in terms of climate disaster, change, mass hunger, and billions of people will be affected. So from the Islamic perspective, I've given you the understanding of the gross world, quantum world and subtle world, and how the divine qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in terms of the various realms from Nasut, Malakut, Jabarut, Lahut and Hahut. In the previous video, I have given you a lot of details in that. And how from the Islamic metaphysics, we have this understanding of our roh, kal, akal and body. And how our body is just one small component of the totality of our existence. So this model in terms of Al-Ghazali, where we have our roh, our kalb and our akal, this is our spiritual domain. They are interchangeable, and our jasad, the physical domain, as we existed on this earth. When Allah manifested us to exist on this earth, we have this physical domain. And when we return to Allah, we have the intact, the SEM, the SEM, a spiritual, emotional and mental self. The heart, the roh, the heart and the mind and the jasad. Alright, the imprint of the jasad will affect us in the realm of the hereafter based on the amal and the iman as we exist on this earth. So how are we going to understand the spiritual, emotional, mental affecting our physical body? I've given to you in the previous video in terms of the placebo effect, auto-suggestion, Pygmalion effect, quantum field effect, and understanding of the five levels, streams of the existence. And today I'm going to give you another idea, a very important idea, because how actually our dependence on the physical materialism in terms of medicine, in terms of healing, has given us only a small aspect of the reality of healing. So under Islamic Integrative Healing, IIH, remember, this is the method that we are going to promote to the world using positive stigma psychology framework. What is important is we know that our spiritual, emotional and mental domains, that means our S, our roh, our kalb and our akal, these are the intact domain coming to us from the realm of when we were created in the realm of Alastu Rabbikum. The realm when Allah, in the Azal, when Allah created us, we came into being with this domain. We have the spiritual domain, we have the emotional domain and the mental domain. They are interchangeable. According to Imam Ghazali, these are interchangeable, but they are basically one. Alright? Then we have the physical domain as we exist on this earth. So what is important is we know that the spiritual, emotional and mental domain actually can overcome all cellular, all physical domains. That means all cellular level, at whatever cellular level, for example, at cellular level, you already have hundreds or thousands or millions of cancer cells floating within your cellular system now. But you don't get cancer. Why? Because Allah has ordained your immune system, in terms of your existence as the spiritual, emotional, and mental self, that cancer cell cannot replicate or multiply. It just floats around, and it is every one of us have cancer cells all the time, but it is under control. All right. So, what is important is when you go on to physical medicine, you just rely on your physical intervention. That means you have cancer, you have surgery, or you have chemotherapy, or you have any kind of radiation. Either you cut, or you radiate, or you just use very, very difficult techniques at the physical level to try to intervene. But that is ineffective. Maybe it is effective at the placebo effect. Maybe 30% of the case it works. But to really be effective, we can harness the nature of our SEM, spiritual, emotional, mental self. That means in terms of our ibadah, in terms of our reliance on Allah, in terms of our confidence that Allah has given us enough internal power. For the traditionalists, for example, in the Chinese system, they have the qi, you have the internal energy that you can then use this internal qi to attack the cancer cells. And this is proven. All right. Or for those who are positive thinkers, you use your positive thinking, and then you tell yourself you are healed. So there are many methods. So you are directing your mental self, your emotional self. But in Islam, we are directing the three areas: your mental self, your emotional self, and your spiritual self. You direct it to your cancer cell. So how to do that? This is where the Islamic integrative healing method can give you an upper hand. So we should not just think that, oh, this is modern medicine, that this old thing talking about spiritual self, emotional, mental self. No, these are realities of your existence. And if you can harness them, inshallah, I'll show you how to harness them, especially when you are having cancer. How are you going to overcome it? Naturally, using Islamic integrative healing methodology as we go along. Or you have diabetics, or you have pain in the joints, you have so many of the diseases, one by one, inshallah, I will give you an approach, scientific, but complementary to it is the harnessing of your domain in terms of your spiritual, emotional, and mental, your roh, your qalb, and akal. And if we can do that, inshallah, you would be able to heal yourself with the grace and the mercy of Allah. That means healing is not just taking just some pills or some medicine, but an integrated understanding of the nature of yourself and the powers within which Allah has given you. In terms of your spiritual power, your emotional power, and your mental power, reacting or acting upon your physical domain, which is nothing. And you can completely transform yourself and achieve the highest level of healing, the highest level of wellness, the highest level of success in this world and the hereafter, inshallah.